Hello everyone, today we are going to solve 2D truss problem using Ansys workbench static structural. So now let's go to Ansys workbench, and this is static structural. Go to engineering data. Now click here, create a new material. Drag and drop isotropic elasticity to the new material and add Young's modulus. Young's modulus is 200 gigapascal and mu is 0.3. So it's gigapascal, megapascal, 200 gigapascal. So that 200 times the power of 3 megapascal gives us 200 gigapascals. Now 0.3 Poisson's ratio. Now go to geometry, click design modeler. Click on XY plane, look at face or plane, go to sketching. Now take polyline, three lines. I have drawn three lines, open end, 1, 2, 3. Same as 1, 2, 3, and this is 3.6 meters, and the unit is, by default the unit is meter. So now let me give dimension, this one 3.6 meters. So everything is 3.6. now I'll just go to constraint, I'll say equal length. So now it has changed. Now again same for the third line. Equal three lengths. Okay. Now we have to draw three triangles. So again draw, take polyline, go for P, just draw it randomly. P, connect to P every time. It's a P stands for point. Okay, now open end. Yeah, now on a dimension, if you see the dimension here is 3.14 meters vertical dimension. So I'll take vertical from this point to this point, vertical, and it is 3.14. So now this is the triangle. Now let's go and give the same constraint, equal length. Equal length. So now again for the third triangle. Okay, now again same for this one. Okay, take the same polyline, connect P to to P to P opened. So now we have our 2D truss. Now go to modeling, line from sketches, apply this sketch, generate. But we have not given the cross section. So concept, cross sectional area, circular. Now the radius, now let me just change to millimeters. So yeah, millimeters. So that is 32.16 mm of click generate. So circular truss. Now let's go to meshing. So now on the geometry, change the material. New material. Now create mesh. I'll take this one, this one. Apply. I'll say number of division. Let's say 80. Okay. Duplicate. Now take this edge, this edge, apply. I'll just add 100. Okay, now again same, duplicate, this time this one, this one, and this one, apply. 120 or 110. Okay, now I'll say generate mesh. Looks okay. If you go under statistics, you have around 1000 elements, 2000 nodes. That's okay. Now go to select fixed support and apply on this edge. This is fixed support, and this one remote displacement. X component is free to move, Y component is constant, so is every other component. 0, rotation 0, 0, 0. Okay. Now add force. Apply on this one, force. Consider components on the Y component. It is 280, 280, 280. Okay, so 280, 280, 280, 360 kilonewtons. Negative direction minus 280 kilo, three zeros, newtons. Okay, now same, duplicate, duplicate. Apply this one. Apply this one. Now again, one more time, duplicate. Select this vertex. apply. It is 360 kilonewtons. 360 kilonewtons. 30. So now deformation, total deformation, stress, we don't have unable to get those values, only deformation. So first let me solve for okay, so now this is deformation of 2D truss. But if you see result, that is auto scale, it is set to auto scale, set to true scale. So this will be our true deformation. So very little deformation, 9.1 mm in mm of deformation, maximum deformation, that too in this segment. So yeah, it has changed. If you set to undeformed and you change to true scale, you will see little variation. See that? Sorry, undeformed, true scale, a little bit of change happened there, but it has okay. Now let me okay, I'll just this one. So now go to here, select beam selection results, set to yes, because we have used a line body. To get our stress strain results, we have to use this beam selection region, then only we can get stress and strain. But evaluate all results. So this is our stress, 116 megapascal is our stress. Here is a minimum stress, whereas the total deformation has happened. Maximum total deformation is in this triangle, minimum stress is in this one. Okay,